nursing audit. Maybe the word audit is not familiar to you. Audit means nothing. It is the official examination of quality. You are examining the quality. For example, suppose if you go to a market and you want to purchase vegetables, so you will check the quality, no? Or while you are purchasing dress, you will check the quality of the dress, right? Or else if you want to drink water, you will buy mineral water. You are checking the quality, or you are giving importance to the quality. So audit means simply you can say it is the official examination of quality. You are evaluating or examining the quality of a thing. So what is meant by nursing audit? Nursing audit means the examination of the quality of nursing care. It is the examination of the quality of nursing care. So you can define nursing audit as it is the process of evaluating the appropriateness and effectiveness of nursing care. It is the process of evaluating the appropriateness and effectiveness of nursing care. How properly you are giving and how much effectiveness is there. That is, it is the process of evaluating the appropriateness as well as the effectiveness of nursing care. Got it? Next one is the classification of nursing audit. Nursing audit is classified into retrospective as well as concurrent nursing audit. Retrospective as well as concurrent nursing audit. Retrospective audit means it is a past record. You are checking the records. The patient is not there. Already discharge is finished and you are checking the record regarding the nursing care given to the patient, and you are checking the quality of care is received to that patient or not. The patient is not there, you are checking the record. So it is a past checking. But in concurrent, the patient is there at the time of giving care. A nurse is giving care to the patient. That time only the audit is conducting. Got it? So while giving the care only, audit is conducting. That time the audit is carried out. Another classification is internal audit and external audit. Internal as well as external audit. Internal audit means the person within the hospital or within the department only, nurses only in the hospital, they are conducting the audit. That is internal audit. From internally only they are conducting the audit. But external audit means some other agency, external source is coming to conduct the audit. That is external audit. Not from the inside. From outside only the audit is conducted. Some outside agency is coming. So audit is classified into retrospective and concurrent audit, as well as another classification is internal audit as well as external audit. Next we can see the audit process. How you are conducting a audit, or how to conduct a audit. It is conducted in three phases. Three phases are there. First one is describing phase. Second one is preparing and implementing phase. Last one is analysis and concluding phase. Got it? One by one, let's see. First one is describing phase. In describing phase, first you have to identify the topic. You have to identify the topic. Regarding which topic you are going to conduct the audit. For example, back care. Regarding the back care, you are going to conduct a audit. I'm just giving the example only. Okay, so you selected the topic. Next, you have to form an audit team. You have to make a audit team. At least it should have 5 members in that team. At least 5 members should be there in an audit team. Got it? Next one, set audit criteria and standards. You have to set the audit criteria as well as standards. Regarding the back care, you can set the criteria and standard. What is criteria and standard means? You are setting a up to a level this should be reached. I will give the example. Regarding back care, the criteria is back care is given every 2 hourly or not. So every 2 hourly the nurse should give the back care, or frequently changing position, in every 2 hour the nurse should change the position. or which cream, which moisturizing cream is used to give the back massage. Proper recording is there or not. Hand washing is done or not. These are the criteria, whether these criteria are meeting or not. So first of all, you are setting some criteria. Up to this level, the nurse should perform. That is your criteria, and you can measure it. Getting or not? Next one is develop an audit protocol. You have to develop a audit protocol. The protocol include the objectives. The objectives of the audit regarding the target population. On which department or on which nurses you are going to conduct the audit? Regarding ICU department or emergency department, you can decide. So you have to define that your population is nurses who are working in a particular hospital in the intensive care unit, that is ICU. So you have to define the population, and you have to define the method of data collection in the protocol. You should know which method you are using, other methods including observation or questioning. Which method you are using, you have to define. It will comes under audit protocol. Got it? That's all regarding describing phase. Next phase is preparing and implementing phase. Preparing and implementing phase. In that, you have to prepare the audit tools. You have to prepare the audit tools. In protocol, you have defined the method. So the method is questioning. You have to prepare the audit tool questionnaire. Or if the method is observation, the tool will be checklist or it will be rating scale. It depends upon the audit team. So you have to prepare the audit tool to conduct auditing. Got it? Next one is make a plan for gathering data. You have to make a plan to collect the data. How to collect the data and when to collect the data, whom will collect the data. You have to make a plan before collecting the information, before auditing, you have to make a plan. Okay. Next one is get ethical approval. You have to get the permission. Ethical approval means you have to get the permission from the hospital as well as from the authorities as well as from the patient also. If patient is there, you have to take the consent from them also. Getting or not? Next one is collecting data. After all these procedures, you have to collect the information or you have to collect the data. Getting or not? The last phase is analysis and concluding phase. In analysis and concluding phase, first step is analyze data and compare result. You have already collected the data. Now analyzing the data means you are examining that collected information. You are checking that collected information regarding the back care, and you are comparing the result. You are comparing the result with the criteria and standards. Already you developed a criteria and standards. So whether they are reached or not, up to that level a nurse is giving, or nurse is frequently changing, every 2 hourly a nurse is changing the position of the patient or not. So you are comparing the result with your preset criteria and standards. Got it? I have to analyze the data and you have to compare the result with your standards. Okay. Next, make an audit summary. Afterwards, you have to make an audit summary, means whether the standards had met or not. If not, what was the reason for failure? What was the reason for failure to give the back care according to the standard? What was the reason? You have to write a brief audit summary. Got it? Next one is plan and implement change. You have to plan what are the problems you have identified and how to overcome. You have to plan. And you have to implement the changes to give quality of care to the patient. You have to implement the planned changes. Got it? Finally, again, you have to do a re-audit. You have to do a re-audit to check whether the changes are there afterwards implementing the new things after implementing changes are occurred or not. So finally you have to do a re-audit. Got it? That's all regarding nursing audit. We will meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.